Well, today here in Crystal Lake is Wear Blue for AJ Day. We've seen students after school, families, people coming by this home all day to pay their respects, many of them in tears over the loss of this little boy. And one woman who has taken this particularly hard is a neighbor who lives right across the street. Today she sat down with me and told me vivid details of abuse she says she saw firsthand and did report to authorities. Janelle Butler moved into her home on Dole Avenue in the fall of 2017 and will never forget the first time she met five-year-old AJ Freund, her neighbor right across the street.
They came over trick-or-treat and AJ was dressed like a mummy. And I said, oh, cute mummy costume, what's your name? And she said, he's AJ. And she said, but he's actually not dressed as a mummy. We've been at the hospital all day. I said, oh, what happened? She said, he grabbed a pot of boiling water off the stove and poured it over him. She said that he's even lost part of his hair from it, and he had bald patches on his head and gauze.
This is a photo posted to AJ's mother, JoAnn Cunningham's Facebook page 2 months later.
Yep, exactly. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's from, and that red mark on his head, that's exactly how he looked, but worse when I saw him in October.
Butler says photos of AJ taken over the last 2 years show apparent signs of abuse. Some bruises she says she saw in person and immediately reported to police and DCFS.
I've seen several photos too now that people have shown me and all that, and I think there's little boys do get banged and bruised up, but now that you know what was going on and you see how many, there's no way.
Janelle Butler says she called police and DCFS at least a dozen times over the last 2 years. And since this all unfolded this past week, she's spoken with a lot of her neighbors. They tell us, she says, every single one of them had contacted police as well. Coming up tonight at 7:30, there is a vigil for AJ Freund that is at Lippold Park here in Crystal Lake. And coming up at 5 o'clock, we'll have some more details on funeral arrangements being made for him right now. Live in Crystal Lake, Dana Rebick, WGN News.